السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is your brother Ilham Mu'taz Al-Abd from Chicago. I'm a graduate of Al-Azhar University in Egypt. And right now I'm a resident scholar imam at Furqan Foundation in Chicago to spread the Quran and do da'wah work across the 50 states. I'm based in Chicago, alhamdulillah. My main job next to my imam position is the chair of Arabic and Islamic Studies Department at University School in Chicago. And alhamdulillah, I am your guest speaker today, inshallah ta'ala, and the guest khatib. So inshallah ta'ala, I would have the pleasure on behalf of Furqan Foundation, the organization I am representing and speaking on behalf. Inshallah, I'm going to be giving the khutbah today, inshallah ta'ala. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله لا أبغي به بدلا حمدا يبلغ من رضوانه الأمل. ثم الصلاة على خير الورى وعلى ساداتنا آله وصحبه الفضلا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. All praises be to Allah, and may peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and messenger. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا. O you who believe, be watchful, be mindful and fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not die except in a state of Islam, in a state of full submission to Allah. O you who believe, hold fast to the covenant of Allah, hold fast to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not dispute among one another in your businesses and affairs. May Allah forgive all of our sins and mistakes, and may Allah guide us all to the straight path. Allahumma ameen. Brothers and sisters, imagine if one day you're walking down the street and all of a sudden someone stopped you and he or she are thanking you so much because you saved their life. You've done them a big favor. You've done them a big service. And subhanAllah, for a second, you don't remember if you've ever seen that person before, and you don't even remember our story. Imagine if someone stopped you and all of a sudden they are thanking you so much for what you've done to them. You've done them a big favor. You saved their life, and for a moment you do not even remember if you've seen that person before or not. And you do not even remember what kind of action, what kind of service, how did you save their life. And once again you question them, you ask them, can you please tell me who are you? And they tell you, I am your little good deed, Allah, that you have done in your life. And today I am your path to Jannah. This is one of the scenes on the Day of Judgment. This is one of the situations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would provide you as a surprise for all of your little good deeds and actions that you have done in this life. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he teaches us to do good in our life as Muslims, he said, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Never belittle any good deed, no matter how small it is, simply because this little good deed and action could save your life. And alhamdulillah, our ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen to be a model of goodness. Allah named our ummah in the Quran as the ummah of goodness, and that's quite important. Ummat al-khayr. Allah says in the Quran, who كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. This Ummah is the best Ummah, the Ummah of goodness that Allah has chosen to be a role model for humanity when it comes to goodness. Why? تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. The same verse mentions three beautiful qualities. The first one is تأمرون بالمعروف. You are the Ummah of goodness and the best Ummah because you enjoy what is right. You do what is correct. Any good cause in life, you are number one. You're always there. وتنهون عن المنكر. The second quality is that not only you do what is right, you are against what is wrong. You ban it. You prohibit it. You stand against it. And above all, the third quality, وتؤمنون بالله. You have a firm faith in the only one God, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So imagine, brothers and sisters, we as Muslims, we belong to the Ummah of goodness that Allah has chosen to be a model, not only for ourselves, but for all humanity. Alhamdulillah, it is an honor, but it is a responsibility. You belong to that Ummah. Even our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad, he was a power of goodness himself. Before his da'wah, during his life and after his death. Before his da'wah, they used to call him As-Sadiq Al-Ameen, the trustworthy, the truthful, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. During his life, he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, taught us that the best investment with Allah is doing good. So we as Muslims believe in Allah and do ibadah, but meanwhile, we do as many good deeds as we can because this is the true investment for this ummah. And because of that goodness, alhamdulillah, we do exist today. And when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, he left behind his legacy, a legacy of goodness. So we belong to the ummah of goodness, and we should know that very well and act upon it. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, معلم الناس الخير, the one who taught humanity how to do good. He's a power of goodness. And alhamdulillah, Allah in the Quran, when he commanded us to worship him, Allah commanded us also to do good. In the same verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اَرْكَعُوا وَاسْجُدُوا وَاعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَفَعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. It's a very beautiful verse that carries four commands. And it begins with iman and it ends with success. And the message is very clear. What begins with iman, inshallah, it ends with success in this life and the next. But what is in between? What is the roadmap of success? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear. All you who believe, make ruku and sujood. Maintain your salah. Maintain your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a strong proof of your iman. Not only this, wa'budu rabbakum. And make sure you make ruku and sujood only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And do good that you may succeed. Subhanallah. We're commanded to maintain our connection with Allah through salah. We're commanded to worship Allah alone. And we are commanded to do good. So doing good in Islam, brothers and sisters, is not an option. It's not a favor that you do to someone. It's mandatory upon you because it's a command in the Quran. You do good because you belong to the Ummah of goodness. Because your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a power of goodness. And because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you in the Quran to do good. Not only this, another beautiful aspect of doing good in Islam, Allah named it a business with him. When you do something good, no matter how small it is a business with Allah, not with people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا فَيُضَاعِفَهُ لَهُ أَضْعَافًا كَثِيرًا. Who amongst you would have that business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, would give a loan to Allah and Allah would pay it off and pay it back in many, many multiples. In another beautiful verse, Allah named it tijara. Tijara means a trade. So when you do something good, even smiling at someone's face, subhanallah, it is a tijara. It's a trade with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُورُ. Indeed, those who recite the word of Allah, the Quran, establish their salah,
And those who spend and give from what Allah has provided for them publicly and privately, those are the ones who hope for a business or a trade with Allah that will never fail. Allahu Akbar. The only business that will never fail, and I think we all know that as Muslims, it is the business with Allah. It will never fail. Any business in life, any trade you have in life, you have a chance of 50-50 to win or to lose. We know that very well. But keep in mind that whenever you do something good as a Muslim, as someone who belongs to the best ummah, the ummah of goodness, as someone whose prophet is a power of goodness, as someone who's commanded in the Quran to do good, as someone whose job is to have business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of these factors together, definitely your business will never fail. Brothers and sisters, another beautiful aspect of doing good in Islam is that whenever we do something good, we do it seeking the pleasure of Allah, for the sake of Allah only. We do not expect any appreciation, no recognition from anyone. That must be your intention as a Muslim. You train yourself, and you educate yourself, and your society and community that, yes, we belong to the Ummah of goodness, true. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a power of goodness, of course. We are commanded in the Quran to do good because it's mandatory upon us. Yes, of course. We do it as a business with Allah. Definitely. But meanwhile, make sure you do it only for the sake of Allah. Don't expect your name to be on the walls. Do not expect your name to be mentioned in the media reports or on social media. That's not your intention as a Muslim. Allah gave us an example in the Quran of those who feed the poor and the needy. And they said, we do so seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We expect no appreciation, no recognition from anyone whomsoever. We expect it only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. Only appreciation and recognition and gratefulness comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what we hope for. Alhamdulillah, this is our business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's our life. Every day you wake up in the morning, you think of your ibadah and you think of your good deeds and actions, what you do in this life. And you think of, Ya Allah, even if it's my job, even if it's a sign in, sign out, but what is in between, between sign in and sign out, Ya Rabb, it's for your sake. To serve my family, to serve my community, to serve my country, to serve humanity in general, Muslims and non-Muslims. That must be your intention. This is the business and the trade you have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, another beautiful aspect of doing good in Islam, we never show off. Riya. Riya means showing off. And again, you do not speak of what you do. You never remind people of what kind of service or any favor you've done to them. Don't speak of it. Do not remind them of what you've done. Make it between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah reminds us in the Quran of that beautiful aspect of doing good as Muslims. Allah says in the Quran, الَّذِينَ يُنفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنفَقُوا مَنًّا وَلَا أَذَى لهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Those who spend their money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they never follow up their sadaqah with any reminders nor hurtful speech. Don't hurt the feeling of those who receive it. Don't even show up. Don't let them know if you can hide it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ورجل تصدق بصدقة فأخفاها حتى لا تعلم شماله ما تنفق يمينه. And a person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give a full share of reward on the day of judgment, the one who gave sadaqa to the extent that his left hand doesn't know what the right hand did. Of course, it's a metaphor that you hide your sadaqa, that no one hears of it, that you do not even hurt the feelings of those who receive it, that you do not even remind others that you do not show off. Whenever you do something good, make sure you do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So once again, you do good as a Muslim because you belong to the ummah of goodness, ummah al-khayr. And your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the power and inspiration of goodness. And because Allah commanded us in the Quran, so it's mandatory upon you. And it is a business and a trade with Allah as Allah calls it. And you do so seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, appreciation and recognition only from Allah. And you never show off. Subhanallah. See how the Quran is disciplining us, is teaching us how to invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another beautiful aspect of doing good in Islam. And subhanallah, many people fall in this trap. This trap is that we belittle our sadaqah. We belittle what we do. We think it's very tiny. But it's very big with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَحْسَبُونَهُ هَيِّنًا وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. You think it's tiny, it's small, it wouldn't make any difference or a change. But wallahi, definitely it does a big, big change in life and society. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا تَحْقِرَنَّ مِنَ الْمَعْرُوفِ شَيْئًا. Never belittle any good deed you do in this life. وَلَوْ أَن تَلْقَى أَخَاكَ بِوَجْهٍ طَلْقٍ. Even if it's as small as smiling at someone's face, it makes a big difference. Do it. Allah knows you the best. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows your capability. Allah says in the Quran, لينفق ذو سعة من سعته. Those of wealth and richness, give accordingly. Give in abundance. ومن قدر عليه رزقه فلينفق مما آتاه الله. But those of little share in life, let them give as well to the best they can. There is no exemption. Subhanallah, the poor and the rich, both are commanded to give. One gives 100,000, the other can give just $1 or 1 dirham. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the poor among the Sahaba came to him one day and they were complaining. And they said, Ya Rasulallah, ذهب أهل الدثور بالأجور. The people of wealth and richness, how lucky they are. They got the best of this life and the next. In this life, Allah provided for them a lot. So with their money and wealth, they can do anything. MashaAllah, they can afford anything in life. Not only this, whenever you ask them to give, they give in abundance. We could not match, definitely. And the much they give, the higher position in Jannah they secure. So we lost it both. We couldn't do anything in this life, and in the life after we could not even match them, which is not fair. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught them a beautiful lesson. That's not the equation. It's not how it works with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, سبق درهم 100,000 dirham. Have you ever heard of the $1 or 1 dirham that exceeded in reward 100,000? And they say, how it's possible, Ya Rasulallah? And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them the beautiful lesson that a man of $2 only in pocket, they are in a dire need for help. And you ask them to help you, and he or she gave you one of the $2 they do have. Technically, they give you 50% of their wealth and money. Is it equal in reward with someone who gave 100,000 and it's even below 1% of what Allah has given to them? It's never the same. And this is a beautiful example for all of us. Don't belittle what you do. If you put your hand in your pocket, grab it out and give it for the sake of Allah. Allah knows you the best. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا ما آتاها. Allah would never overburden you beyond your capacity. سيجعل الله بعد عسر يسرا. After hardship comes ease by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So once again, brothers and sisters, this is our ummah, the ummah of goodness. And that's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepares us and guides us and teaches us how to invest with Him. Doing good in Islam is mandatory upon all of us. Doing good is a business with Allah. Doing good is only for the sake of Allah. No appreciation, no recognition from anyone, only from Allah. Doing good in Islam, we do not show off. We ask Allah to give us sincerity in our intentions, in word and action. And doing good in Islam, no matter how small it is, we do it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who receives it, and Allah appreciates whatever we do, no matter how small it is. تقبل الله منا ومنكم أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله لا أبغي به بدلا. حمدا يبلغ من رضوانه الأملا. ثم الصلاة على خير الورى وعلى ساداتنا آله وصحبه الفضلاء. Brothers and sisters, الحمد لله رب العالمين that we belong to this ummah. And the Quran speaks to us all the time. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم left behind his legacy and left his sunnah to guide us. And because of that goodness of the ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, الحمد لله, we continue to exist and expand. Remember that story of that man 14 centuries ago who stood up in the desert of Arabia in the middle of nowhere. And he said the following, لا يبلغن هذا الأمر ما بلغ الليل والنهار. This matter of our deen, this Islam will be everywhere on planet earth, whether they like it or not. And subhanAllah, this man was Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم 14 centuries ago. And Arabia was nothing but a desert. And if Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم belittled his work and his effort, we would never be Muslims today in Florida and North America in 2024. We wouldn't have all of these, mashallah, massive and big masajid everywhere in the country. We wouldn't have all of these masses of Muslims among the Arabs and non-Arabs. Actually, the Arabs wouldn't exceed 250 million. Okay, so this is the community of Prophet as an Arab person. But beyond that, look at all of these faces. It is the investment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all come here. We all pray behind one imam. We all recite the same Quran in the same exact manner that has been given to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Islam does exist in America today because of all of you. And if every one of us said, no, I wouldn't make a big difference. I'm going to stay home or I can't pray home. Wallahi, we would never have Jumu'ah and Jama'ah. But because of you, alhamdulillah, we say that Islam does exist in America and we have Jumu'ah and Jama'ah because of you. And this is another beautiful aspect of doing good in Islam that Allah makes use of you. People are of two categories. Those whom Allah makes use of and those whom Allah excludes. Allahumma istamilna wa la tastabdil bina ahada. We always make that beautiful dua. Ya Allah, always include us. Make use of us. Do not replace us with someone else. Do not exclude us from goodness. Because Allah said in the Quran, keep in mind, وَإِن تَتَوَلَّوْا يَسْتَبْدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ. If you turn away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would replace you with someone else. So this is a good news, alhamdulillah. If Islam reached us 14 centuries after the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is a higher chance that this deen will continue to exist for another 14 centuries, inshallah. And as we all believe, it will continue until the day of judgment. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. All assets of Islam are still there. Communities are still there. Masajid are still there and expanding. And alhamdulillah, this community and this place that is serving as a masjid today, only Allah knows how this place is going to be in 50 years from now. How many masajid like this we're going to have. Our representation and our presence in this country. How? It's because of the investment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those before us, alhamdulillah, jazahum Allahu khayra. Perhaps we don't know any of them. Perhaps some of them, or even all of them, they do not exist with us anymore. But because of them, alhamdulillah, we search the masjid, we find the masjid nearby. Not only one masjid, mashallah. If you type the word masjid on maps, mashallah, you have all of this big network of masajid. And this is for me a truth enough. And this is truthful enough that the promise of Allah to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came true. And alhamdulillah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment will be so proud of all of his followers that subhanallah, we all believed in him. We all fulfilled and carried his message even we have not seen him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we promise to commit ourselves to invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in goodness. So we prepare the way inshallah ta'ala for future generations. So what we do inshallah today, it reflects the future of Islam, and that's why everyone must be included. At the moment we build a new masjid, subhanallah, some people might give 100,000, 1 million, and others who give $1 and $2. And if you ask the person giving $1 or $2, they might belittle it and say, no way, $1 would never build the masjid. But when we put all money together, the masjid is built. So the $1 wouldn't make sense at the moment, subhanAllah, you give it, but later on when the whole picture is full, now you can see the impact of you. Never belittle any good deed you do in this life. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it is an investment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. do it and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes care of it. Wallahi subhanallah, the Quran is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what you see in my hands are two of the best translations of the Quran. And alhamdulillah, many of you, mashallah, you're very big supportive of our cause, of da'wah cause that we do across the 50 states through our Clear Islam teams. And alhamdulillah, one of those teams is here in Orlando. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Your brothers and sisters at Furqan Foundation in Chicago, we've been in this business in the past 20 years, spreading the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, two of the best translations of the Quran. So Furqan Foundation is the main and only provider of all of these translations of the Quran to all da'wah working teams, to all prisons in America. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And every year we pass out more than 500,000 copies of the Quran. 500,000 copies, 500,000 people read the Quran because of all of you. And for me, it is a chain of supply. Each one of us are doing their job. I do my job. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked me on the day of judgment, what did you do for da'wah? And I said, Ya Allah, I took the stage, I speak, I give khutbah, I encourage people to donate and support your cause, inshallah. And whenever someone asks about Islam, I will do my job. And each and every single one of you, by the way, will be questioned. What did you do for your deen? What did you do for Islam? And it's quite important. And you're not all expected to take my position to speak. No, that's not the only way we make da'wah. Da'wah is a chain of guidance, let's call it, inshallah. And each and every one of us has a job to do. And alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we never belittle the power of the Quran. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it mandatory upon all of us to pass the Quran on his behalf. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بَلِّغُوا عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. Pass the knowledge of the Quran on my behalf, even if it's just one verse. One verse, really? One verse would make a big difference? Definitely it will. How many people converted to Islam after reading few lines of the Quran? Umar ibn al-Khattab, one of the founder fathers of Islam, one of the 10 people secured and guaranteed Jannah, inshallah. How was Umar ibn al-Khattab the night he became Muslim? And how Umar became a Muslim, we all know the story. But the good part about it is that his sister Fatima gave him a piece of paper that has like 7 or 8 lines only of the Quran. 7 or 8 lines of the Quran were enough to convince Umar ibn al-Khattab from being one of the biggest enemies of Islam to one of the biggest advocates and supporters of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And subhanallah, he left his position in Jahannam to his position in Jannah. And he got the glad news and the bishara from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So definitely, Umar insha'Allah, jazahullahu anna kulla khayr, for all what he did for Islam, he will be in Jannah. Only for reading few lines of the Quran. Subhanallah, his sister Fatima could ignore him, could kick him out of her house. But subhanallah, she did that little act of giving him, these are verses of the Quran. Go read it. A story from our time, and perhaps, who doesn't know Sheikh Yusuf Estes? Subhanallah, a white Christian priest whose main job was to defend Islam and Muslims. And he used to do that job with dedication. Until one of the brothers, subhanallah, he took a copy of the Quran and he said, listen, take this, read it, go and educate yourself. Have you read the Quran? No. Do you know anything about Islam? Nothing. Go and educate yourself before you attack Islam. And we have one of two scenarios, right? Either he takes it or threw it away. And I have one story for that. So Sheikh Yusuf, alhamdulillah, he picked it up. He went home, he read a few pages of it. And subhanallah, look who is Sheikh Yusuf Estes today. Isn't it a strong evidence of the power of the Quran? From one of the biggest adversaries and enemies of Islam to one of the biggest dua of our time. How many people converted to Islam because of him? Every time we come to the masjid ourselves, Sheikh Yusuf Estes, mashallah, he comes with hundreds of people, of converts coming back to Islam because of him. So there is one hero in this story that we do not mention. We speak all the time of Sheikh Yusuf Estes, of the converts, but there is one person we do not mention very often. The one who gave him that copy of the Quran. Imagine, Allah has a share of reward for that person, for everyone who becomes a Muslim because of him. So subhanallah, this person could be any one of you if you sponsor any number of these copies of the Quran and we give it out. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We have many da'wah working teams, and the good news, wallahi, from Brother Atif, May Allah bless him. Wallahi, he shares some good news from that community. That in the prison he goes to give khutbah there, he gave me that, alhamdulillah, we passed out more than 1,000 copies of this Quran. And how many people took shahada? At least 150 people. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. 150 people became Muslims for just reading the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every year we pass more than 500,000 copies of the Quran. This year, inshallah ta'ala, we hope to pass out more than 1,000,000 copies of the Quran. You know what's going on in our for our people in Gaza. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alleviate all of their hardship and tension. But because of the tough situation in Gaza, we have a lot of high demand on these translations of the Quran. So unlike any time before, subhanallah, high demand that we're not able to respond to, we ask you all, inshallah ta'ala, to give part of your sadaqah and zakah. Our project is sadaqah and zakah eligible to sponsor any number of these translations of the Quran. If you sponsor one box of the Quran, it has only 52 copies of the Quran. So this is an amount of $104 only, inshallah ta'ala. We're looking for a big sponsorship, inshallah, to match our goal to pass out 1,000,000 copies of the Quran. So you can sponsor any number of copies, inshallah. One box, as I just mentioned, $104, right after Salah, inshallah. We have our table outside, so please, I know you are rushed. Even if you are rushed, you can come back tonight, inshallah. We have a night program as well, and a family program, inshallah, ta'ala, with dinner. So we expect to see you today after Salah, and we expect you at dinner, inshallah, ta'ala. What is the reward for all of that? We do this job for free, by the way. We give Quran copies out for free as a gift from Muslim communities to our fellow brothers and sisters among non-Muslims. The reward is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. If Allah makes use of you to guide only one person, that's better for you than the whole world and what is therein. Imagine if you sponsor that copy of the Quran and it falls at the hand of someone and he or she becomes a Muslim because of you. Subhanallah. You remember the story I mentioned at the very beginning? Someone coming to you, thanking you so much, smiling at your face, telling you, I am so and so, and because of that copy of the Quran, I became a Muslim, and here is your pass to Jannah. So inshallah ta'ala, you're secured a pass to Jannah for guiding and saving one soul, one person from the hellfire. May Allah continue to make use of all of us, inshallah ta'ala, and may Allah forgive all of our sins and mistakes. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala man adana. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم كل إخواننا المستضعفين في غزة, اللهم كل إخواننا المستضعفين في غزة, اللهم أمدهم بمددك, اللهم أيدهم بجندك, اللهم اجعل الدائرة لهم على عدوهم وعدوك يا رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة, إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
الله أكبر, الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة.